Welcome again. We have successfully saved that session. So far, I have received few questions. Let me try and answer them. The first question which was raised is, and if can children of beneficiary be an attesting witness? I think I recall that the when we talk of the beneficiaries, the disadvantage which a benefit. Just start again. Allow me 2 minutes so that other people will join in. Now, since we have started a new session, I'll briefly touch on something. Is how is a will proved in a court? What is the process of bringing it to a court? The normal circumstances by which a will is brought to a court is through a probate or a letter of administration. The difference between a probate and letter of administration is that a letter of administration necessarily, a letter of administration may be with a will or without a will, whereas a probate necessarily has to have a will. Now the issue is, if there is a will, there are two wills, how do you choose whether one has to go for probate or letter of administration? In that circumstance, one has to look at the will. If the will names an executor, you decide, then it has to be a probate petition. If there is no executor named in the will, it becomes a letter, one has to go for a letter of administration. Why do we need this? We need a probate and letter of administration for the reason that this is a document by which the executor or beneficiary will step into the shoes of the testator. When you look at a property law, the property can't be left to be open and unattended. There has to be an owner attached to it. So the moment a person dies, probate and letter of administration is a document which connects it to the next person. But probate and letter of administration as statutorily is required only in presidency towns, which is Bombay, Calcutta and Madras. Rest of the country, there is no necessity of having it. You can prove it through the other circumstances, through other legal proceeding, be it partition, injunction or whatever is the requirement of the law. Now I'll take through the questions which I have received so far. The first question which came is, can children of beneficiary be added as an attesting witness? I recall when the bar which is existent for a beneficiary, that if he acts as an attesting witness, the will to that extent is void, applies to his children as well. So therefore, if the beneficiary's children are added as an attesting witness, the will is void to that extent by which a benefit is given to them. The second is, if attesting witness marries beneficiary at a later stage, does it affect the will? Well, the answer is no. What has to be tested is on the date of execution of a will. If on the date of execution of will they were not married, this should not act as a hindrance, because the words used in the act is the children and not the spouse. The third question which has come is, can two beneficiaries be the only two attesting witnesses to a will so as to attest for properties for which one is entitled? Can two beneficiaries be the only two attesting witnesses to a will so as to attesting for properties to which one is entitled? Well, I would say yes, if I understand the question correctly, is that there are two properties, A1 and 2. A, by the will, A gets 1 and B gets 2. B gets the other property. The will, according to me, the will not be considered to be valid, because the bar of attesting witness acting as a beneficiary would come in here anyway, as in regards to the property for which they would be benefited. It may be true for the other part, but please understand, you can't choose by property. Both the people are there at this given point of time, and the hurdle or the bar which would come in both the circumstances. one question is, can attesting witness be beneficiary under the will? I have dealt with very categorically. Beneficiary can be an attesting witness, but will to that extent is void. Next is, what point should be taken into consideration at the time of drafting regarding witness? Well, I stated earlier, the witnesses, when you are choosing the witness, you should choose witness younger in age than the testator. You should, as far as possible, choose the witnesses who are not strangers, and the witnesses should be those who should be friendly or who should be known to the beneficiaries, that those who will come to the court to depose in favor of the beneficiary, or who would respect to the testator that after his demise they will come to the rescue of their family members who are the beneficiaries. The next question is, can privileged will be converted into an unprivileged will? The answer is no. A privileged will is valid only for a period of 6 months after the cessation of the war. If the person dies during the war, the will comes into effect. If he survives 6 months, the will loses its importance. He will have to execute another will. The other question which came here is, can a testator who is also a beneficiary, can son of a testator who is also a beneficiary, can also be a beneficiary? I have just answered. Son of a testator who is attesting witness also be a beneficiary? The same. The answer is same. The beneficiary run the same hurdle. Can a will dispute suit be connected with partition suit during trial? Well, the answer is yes in regard to non-presidency towns. In presidency, you have to go in for probate and letter of administration. A partition suit would not help. In rest of the country, yes. Are there any more questions? I see there are some more questions. Please quickly send your questions. I don't think they teach wills in court. In college, whether a clause will help that the testator is executing the will with the intention of will only. Well, you can't have a clause to that effect, that it is with an intention of a will only. But in case you can use a in a will, in case of where the will is drafted in a language which is not known to the testator, or the testator is an illiterate, you can write a clause that the will has been read over to the testator in a language understood by them. The clause part, in response to your question, the clause part can't help. This will have to be led by way of evidence. Any more questions? Yeah, there are coming, right. You know, will is a document. If you look at in civil litigation, whenever you join litigation, in my view, this is the most tricky part of the trial court practice, the most difficult. It's like saying what you have a brain in brain surgery in medicine field, one wrong touch here and everything is gone. One must clearly understand how a will is proved and how cross-examination should be done. I was going through one of the judgment, and which is a matter of fact, people who do not know how to lead evidence or cross-examine at times prove the will during cross-examination without realizing that while the matter is on, the will, while the examination in chief is being led, there is the will has not been proved, but they do put certain questions by which will gets proved. While I am waiting for those questions to come in, I like to point out there is something which is known as a mutual will. The mutual will is will where two persons together make a will. Husband and wife together make a will. And in most of the circumstances, in all likelihood, one of them would predecease the other. In this case, in case of mutual will, the will can't be changed by the surviving testator after the death of the other person who has made the will. The will becomes open and it can't be used. The next question is, for a will to be unnatural, only inheritance property is considered, or also self-owned property to exclude any son from inheritance property is considered or a cell phone property to exclude any son from will. Let's understand very clearly, when we talk of testamentary jurisdiction of a court, whether it is by probate, largely in probate and letter of administration, they will not get into the question whether the testator was the owner of the property or not the owner of the property. Let's understand, you make a will, their job is only to see whether the will has been executed in accordance with law. Two, answering to your question, the unnatural will being a suspicious circumstance would apply equally to inherited property or to the property which is self-acquired. It has no limitation that it cannot be used for, there is no classification that it can be used only for one of the things. The next question is it necessary to go for probate before transfer of immovable property by means of a registered sale deed? Well, yes and no. In presidency towns, absolutely necessary. But in Delhi and rest of the country, it is not necessary. You can transfer the sale deed. Every other person who is a beneficiary there can be joined as a confirming party, or it may be acted upon through a partition suit or by no objection certificate. There are several ways of doing it. There would not be a problem. Any more questions? Okay, I see one more questions, and perhaps I'll take one or two more thereafter. What if someone buys a separate property after writing a will? Well, good question. That will would not go. The will deal only to the extent of property which have been described in the will. Any property which was acquired subsequent to that would not be governed by the will. However, if the will states that any property which I acquire by a particular after the execution of will goes to such a so and so, then only in that circumstances it would be valid. Otherwise, it cannot be valid. The next question is, can a will be registered through GPA? Well, I don't think so, that a will can be registered through GPA. Will is something which should come through the person. While we talking of registration of a will, I must also say that will as a document does not require to be registered. It is not one of those compulsorily registrable document by the Registration Act. And two, even if a will is registered, it does not add a very great value. It is limited to an extent that it definitely brings you to a level better than that, but it does not mean the will is proved in execution, improved in law. Any more questions, please? I don't think any question coming in. Thank you very much for listening patiently. If you have any questions, you may raise it on the Instagram. I'd be happy to answer it through email or otherwise. Thank you. Thank you very much. Stay safe and stay secure.